This is Dawn from Dare to Be Creative, and I am here to invite you to join my other channel. So first I want to say welcome to this particular channel. I appreciate you stopping by and saying hello and checking out my videos and liking and subscribing and hitting that notification button so that you can see more. But I also want to invite you to another channel that I have, which is called His Scribe, HZSCRIBE, and the description will be in the link below. And on that channel, I started it, what year is this, 22? Couple years ago, I started out with in 2020 to do my planning and my scripture planning. So these were the two that I started out with here. And as you'll see, when the pandemic hit, bam, things changed. But then I also in 21 I started doing some things a little different in my planner, and then 22. So I will just show you real quickly. Didn't do much with my monthly spreads, but what you will find on this one was I did my planning layouts, which I really enjoyed, and I was doing really well consistently every single week making a layout. And then as you'll notice, when we get to the pandemic, I kind of like fell off. It was like, okay, because we weren't going to work and, you know, life just kind of stood still. But anyway, so that's my planner layouts, which I really had fun doing those. And of course you can find all of these up on my Instagram, His Scribe, with those and how I made those. The videos are there as well. And then I think I stopped maybe in April. Yeah, around that time frame. I made a little further than I thought. Yep, so April was the end of that. So that was my planner layouts that I did. And I thought they were really cute. So I may or may not go back to doing that. I don't know, but that's what I started out with. That was the planning. And then I had also started out with scripture writing. I was doing, I had the word love. So on the left-hand side, I was doing all the scriptures I could find pertaining to love. And then I was doing my weekly scripture layout and just decorating it. And I think both of these fell off around the same time. I didn't finish doing this. The word love, I stopped doing it. And then I think I stopped my scripture writing around the same time. But I had a really good time doing this. I like decorating my scriptures, and I preferred in the Bible. Yep, I stopped right there, so I didn't go any further in this planner. So that was in 2020. And then in 2021, I was determined to do things a little bit more consistent, regardless of what's going on in the world. Because I read the Bible through every year anyway. So I said, I might as well go back to doing my scripture writing. So I did. And I'm going to do a flip through of what I did in 2021. Of course, all my pictures are on my Instagram. So this is 2021, my scripture writing. And love for you to join me in doing that. If you like scripture writing, to come and check out my layouts for that. Each one is a little different based on stickers and just different things. I don't typically do the monthly spread for the scripture writing ones. And so I read the Bible through chronologically. And I've been doing that since 2020. A couple years in between, I did read it a different order, but in the order that the Bible's put it in. But I like the chronological order better because it makes more logical sense to me versus grouping the reading it based on the different books. So these are just some of my spreads, and I went through different phases where I wanted them busy, where I wanted them clean, where I wanted just more text, more script, I mean more washi, more background. So, and I have a flip through on my other channel as well, but I just wanted to show you. In case you're interested, this is, you know, a new year. Meant to have this video up earlier. In case anybody is doing that or want to follow along or interested in doing that. I'm a KJ girl, King James. I've been that way all my life. It won't change. I love the King James scripture. If it ain't broke, don't fix it. And then so, yeah. So you can see different scripture, different washi and different sticker collections that I use. It just depends on what was going on that week, the scriptures itself, what kind of spoke to me. The main emphasis, of course, is on writing the scriptures and memorizing scriptures and understanding scriptures, but it does help for you to take the time after you read something to come back and write it, and then decorate it. It kind of connects you to that. So that's what I've been doing with that. So this is just writing the scripture out, and like I said, and then decorating the page. And my style is a little bit different this year. Still doing the scripture writing and still decorating the page, but I'm actually doing a little bit more to the font of the scriptures for this year. And they won't necessarily be the same scriptures that I did last year. Some of them may be the same. But some of them won't, because I'm looking for more visual scriptures to write out. But I just want to do a quick flip through on this channel, in case anybody's interested in that. And so that's the scripture writing, but I'm also doing, in this one, I am not an artist, okay, and don't pretend to be, but I am doing what is called Bible sketch notes. Like if you're doing sermon sketch noting, Bible sketch noting, just people visually representing what are they learning. So I got these binders, these books from, these journals from Michaels. The only downfall about this is that they're not designed for mixed media. I wasn't really thinking about it because I knew I was going to be drawing per se, but the paper, if I could have done it over, I would have got one that was made for wet and dry mixed media, because I can't use the other side of it because markers go through these pages. But nonetheless, I still like it because it does lay flat enough for me to work in it. So as you can see here, I used one of my Creative Memories stencils to make the shapes. But what I did was I just highlighted some information about the Bible itself. And, you know, things like that about how many books and the testaments and different stuff, for how many verses and scriptures. And so what I'm doing each week is I represent the Bible in a biblical way. And I use my stamps and stickers and rub-ons and markers and pens and crayons and stuff like that. But it's to visually represent things that I'm learning and grouping together and things like that. Like, so this one is the bookshelf of how the books are arranged in the Bible, which sometimes people don't know that. And how I color code my Bible so that when I want to find a scripture, I know what color it is. I can remember what type of voice it is that's speaking, if it was the law, history, wisdom, etc. And then I do an outline of every single book, breaking it down from like what's the key word, verse and chapter, who's the author, a survey of the book and some of the key features of that particular book. And then some things that have happened in the book so that even a child can look at this, because trust me, it's drawn like a child because I don't have those artistic abilities. But my goal with this was to leave something behind for my grandkids. If, you know, if a Bible didn't exist, they can see what their grandmother believed and the truth of God's word. So I'm visually representing those things. So this is like the days of creation. This is the primeval period, the first 11 books and the major highlights that happened, you know, from the Garden of Eden all the way from Cain and Abel, Noah, you know, the rainbow, the covenants in Sodom and Gomorrah, so some of those things. And then it's the patriarchal period where we have Abraham and the covenant there, and the 12 tribes being formed and stuff like that, and so, and Joseph and his dreams, so just different things. And then we get into the book of Exodus and plagues, the commandments, just different things, the temple, so I mean the tabernacle. And then so we see different things, how I outline the books, and each book is different, just depends on what I see that's visually I can draw or represent or highlight. I mean, see, like, they're stick people, basically. You know, this is Moses. but his highlights, the reels of his life. The Shema, choosing life and death, and the Torah. So just different things. And then we into the history books and different things here. And it just depends on what I feel is important to, or that I feel moved by to decorate or to visually represent, I do. So I call them sketch noting. It's not truly sketch notes, not truly art, is my version of both in between. So that is what I'm doing there. But I would love for you to come by and check it out. I would love for you even to do the same and show me how you represent those things if you're interested in the Word of God and studying it. And that's where I'm at right now with that. So check out my channel, Hit Scribe. I'd love for you to like and subscribe and to play along with the scripture writing. And I have my journal for this year. with my scripture writing, and what I'm doing here is similar but different. I am doing the scripture in a little bit different fonts. So I just started off with doing this of this at the beginning of the year, and this video is going to probably be up late, but just writing the scripture out and highlighting it and just putting some stuff around it. So just starting this journal because January just started, but yeah. So love for you to check me out. Love for you to read your word, write it, and subscribe it. I mean, write it, decorate it, however you want to do it. But it's a great way to keep yourself encouraged and anchored in these trying times that we're going through, is having that word of God as your shield and your sword and your buckler. So anyway, thank you for watching this video. Thank you for liking and subscribing. And I dare you to be creative. Take care. God bless. Bye-bye.